Good morning students. In this video we are going to start our chapter number 7, that is fractions. Students, in your previous classes you have learned what is a fraction. Now in this video we are going to recall a fraction. A fraction means a part of a whole. I repeat, a fraction means a part of a whole. Where the whole may be a single object or a group of objects. Students, here I have drawn a figure of a rectangle. If you observe here, this rectangle is divided into 6 parts and all parts are equal. Here all 6 parts are equal. Therefore, we can say that this rectangle is divided into 6 equal parts. Students, if I said one part among these 6 parts, then the fraction of this shaded part is 1 divided by 6. I repeat, therefore fraction of this shaded part is 1 divided by 6. Students, this fraction is read as 1/6 or 1 by 6. Therefore, this fraction is read as 1/6 or 1 by 6. Students, in this fraction, upside number is called the numerator and downside number is called the denominator. Therefore, in this fraction, 1 is numerator and 6 is denominator. Therefore, we can write here numerator and this is denominator. Students, in this fraction, numerator stands for number of shaded parts in the given figure and denominator stand for total number of equal parts. Students, if you observe here in this figure, one shaded part, therefore in numerator we can write 1, and in this figure there are total 6 equal parts, therefore in denominator we can write 6. Therefore fraction of this shaded part is 1 by 6 or 1/6. Students, if we shed 2 parts in this figure, then the fraction for these 2 parts in this figure is 2 by 6. Because here 2 shaded parts, therefore in numerator we can write 2 and total 6 equal parts, therefore in denominator we can write 6. Now these 2 numbers divided by 2, 2 1 is 2, 2 3 is 6, therefore fraction is 1 by 3. Students, in this figure if we shed 3 parts, then in numerator we can write 3 and in denominator we can write 6. Therefore 3 by 6. And if you observe here, 3 and 6 divided by 3. Therefore we can divide here 3. 3 1 is 3, 3 2 is 6. Therefore answer is 1 by 2 or fraction is 1 by 2. Students, if we take another example, if in a bucket there are 7 balls and among these 7 balls 4 are blue and 3 are red, then the fraction of each color of balls is, therefore fraction of blue color balls is 4 by 7. Here 4 blue balls, therefore in numerator we can write 4, and total balls 7, therefore in denominator we can write 7. Therefore fraction of red color balls is 3 by 7. Here three red balls, therefore in numerator we can write 3, and total 7 balls, therefore in denominator we can write 7. Therefore fraction of blue color balls is 4/7 and fraction of red color balls is 3/7. Students, if I draw a triangle here and shares some parts of this triangle, then here we cannot write fraction of shaded part by observation, because this triangle is not divided into equal parts. I repeat, in this triangle we cannot write fraction of shaded part because this triangle is not divided into equal parts. Therefore, here we cannot write fraction of shaded part. Therefore, students, we can say that to write the fraction of shaded parts in the given figure, figure must be divided into equal parts. I repeat, to write the fraction of shaded parts in the given figure, figure must be divided into equal parts. Students, I hope it is clear to you. Thank you and have a nice day.